The Royal Society is famous for doing science, publishing science, recognizing science, storing and archiving science.
Obviously.
But it's also really famous for sort of exhibiting it and showing it to the public. And one of the most famous things the Royal Society does are exhibitions. You may know at the moment, and for many, many years now, the Royal Society has something called its Summer Science Exhibition.
That's right.
Which is an amazing thing. Basically, all these rooms here at the Royal Society fill up with people and scientists and exhibits, and all the public come. It's a really great thing to come to. But this isn't just a recent thing, Keith. This has been going for a long time.
It has been going on for a long time. In the Victorian period, the Royal Society was in Burlington House with the Royal Academy, and it held matching exhibitions of science.
All right, and you don't just have to take Keith's word for it. We've got a little bit of evidence for you here. This is a very famous image here at the Royal Society.
Yeah, so this is one of the Royal Society's soirées. Now, in the Victorian period, they would call the summer science exhibition a conversazione, and the evening parties would be called soirées. And here we have the gentlemen of the Royal Society looking at the exhibits laid out on the table for them.
This is a bunch of basically old men in suits, whereas it's all, you get all sorts these days, don't you?
And notice it is all men. So this was the men-only night. There was a ladies' night as well, but this is, as you see, the gents of the period.
Okay. We have something else interesting here. I'll move this picture out of the way. I'll do it very carefully.
Now, like all good exhibitions, they had catalogues of what was on display. Okay. And so here are 10 years' worth of the Royal Society's display exhibits.
So there we go. This is the programmes from 1890 to 1900. There's one in particular that we're interested in, and this is 1896.
That's right, yes.
All right, let's
find the year.
I am curious about what other things you could have gone to look at. Lots of electrical things, lots of things to do with resistance. So electricity was obviously...
New technology, yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. The Meteorological Council had a whole bunch of exhibits going on to do with sea surface temperature. Instantaneous photographs of splashes, which I know is something you find interesting.
Yes,
we were just talking about that before, weren't we? This person is clearly not very good at marketing their work. We have here number 24, specimens of boring marine animals.
By the Marine Biological Association.
I assume we mean boring into stuff.
That's right.
Not dull.
The kind of creatures that would damage ships and piers and so on.
So here we go, Keith. The Royal Society. The president at the time was Sir Joseph Lister.
Very famous name, of course.
Probably most famous for...
antiseptic surgery.
Oh, yeah, okay. Listerine.
That's right, yeah.
Oh, okay, there we go. All right. May 6, 1896. Basically, the number one exhibit was one demonstration in particular.
Practical demonstration of Roentgen's new photography with experiments and exhibition of results.
As difficult to pronounce as his name is, Roentgen. Is an incredibly famous scientist, and he's most famous for pioneering work with X-rays.
Discovered X-rays, yeah.
X-rays. And he was showing off his work, and everyone was coming to see it.
He wasn't here, but the exhibitor was a very interesting fellow of the Royal Society. He wasn't a fellow at this stage. You can see he's Mr. A.A. C. Swinton. One of the things he's famous for is writing a paper which pretty much predicted something called television.
Oh, okay. We see here in the write-up they're talking about, since bone is more opaque to these rays than tissue, it is possible by their means to obtain shadow pictures of the bones in the living body. But we can go one better than just showing you the program. We can show you some stuff, some objects, because Keith's got some. Let's get those.
So these are photographs taken at those 1896 soirees by A.A. Campbell Swinton.
Look at that. This is the hand, looks like it's the left hand, of someone called Armstrong.
That's Lord Armstrong, yes, W.G. Armstrong.
Lord Armstrong's hand. We can do better than that, though, because look at this hand here. That is the hand of Lord Salisbury, who was the Prime Minister at the time.
Yeah, but he was a Fellow of the Royal Society, which is way more important.
Well, I mean, that's important too, but that's amazing. The Prime Minister was coming and thinking, I want to see these bone shadows.
Yeah.
Here's my hand. I'll stick it in the machine or whatever it was they were doing it with.
Yeah.
Here are some more. I mean, to us, this is sort of just pretty standard, isn't it? But this must have just blown their minds.
It did. And Campbell Swinton, interestingly, quite soon after this, was beginning to be approached by medical men who realised the possibilities of this kind of technology. He was employed for a while and taking this kind of image for physicians.
Exposed for 4 minutes through a sheet of black vulcanised fibre, 0.0212 inches thick, on January the 18th, 1896.
So that was slightly before the soiree, so they must have taken that and had it printed as a demonstration piece.
Yeah, they must have had that up on the table going, do you want one of these done?
Yep.
Stick your hand in there. Come on, Prime Minister, you want one of them, don't you? What have we got in here, Keith?
Well, these are photographs by the Swan Electric Engraving Company.
And again, around 1896.
Yep, and we can see immediately what's going on here.
What is it with scientists? As soon as they invent anything, they can't wait to throw a frog in there.
Yeah, and you can see the structure of the creature's bones there, which is rather great.
So there's an x-ray, very early x-ray of a frog.
But here, look, we've got things. And this is the idea that you could have hidden objects and the x-rays would reveal what they were.
Okay, so someone, that could be like someone's pocket or something, and we seem to have a key and a corkscrew and a...
There's a coin there, and I don't know quite what this is, but yeah,
What's that, like a shaving blade?
Looks like a straight razor there. Yes. But again, the idea is that you're revealing hidden objects through x-rays. And I'm sure, just like you, people wanted to know what was in the box.
Exactly. You don't even have to open the box.
Yep. There were various versions of these because people got them done quite regularly. But, you know, it's fascinating to have a thing that you can date to a particular event in the way of that particular soiree. But what I love about these more than anything, I think, here we have people taking x-rays of objects in boxes and purses, just personal effects. So here you have airline security before the aeroplane took off.
And a frog.
And a frog. Now these date from the 1890s, so they're pretty early ones, and you might just be able to read that. Can you
Can I hold one, Keith?
Yes, do. It's probably clearer on the pink one here. Can you read that?
It says, the Edison Swan.
That's right. So Joseph Swan's company merged with Thomas Edison's, and they pretty much sewed up the market for these things.